Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and tonight I want to talk to you about a little competition that Frontier themselves have launched about Jurassic World Evolution. It has been posted already to the Jurassic World Evolution subreddit, and of course on their official forums as well, but I feel like out of the people at home watching, you lovely little folks at home, a lot of you will not have spotted this, and maybe we're looking at doing something a bit more interesting in Evolution, or just want to win some cool stuff. So, lights, Camarasaurus, action! Yeah, it's a Frontier competition launched just yesterday. It's running for about a month, so from the 18th of September to the 19th of what comes after September, October. And the goal is basically to produce a video of Jurassic World Evolution using only in-game footage. And the idea is to tell a story or make it funny, make it entertaining, and just produce a short 2 to 3 minute video, upload it to YouTube, unlisted or public, whichever you choose, and then send it into the Frontier community email link. I'll link the actual post down below so you can get the very specific details. But first of all, I just want to make sure you all see this. And secondly, we're going to spitball some ideas for my own videos. I'm considering entering. I think it'd be a pretty cool thing to do. I'd really love to see some of your guys' entries, and we'll probably take a look at some of them at the end. If any of you want to, maybe I'll do my own competition at some point. Frontier, you stole my idea. You had it first, but I'm going to claim it was mine. But basically, you'll make a 2 to 3 minute video of Jurassic World Evolution using purely in-game stuff. Like so. You know, you'd be like this. Ba-da! Don't know how you'd hide the UI, which is unfortunate. Can you completely hide the UI? You could do this, but then nothing moves. You just have to kind of go like this. I don't know what this is meant to be. Or you could hop in. Actually, a good way to do it would be to use the new monorail stuff. So you can show view, and you can see we don't have a UI here, other than the little back in the bottom left. So if you could rig a monorail to somehow show the dinosaurs perfectly, or maybe some of your other attractions, that might be a really good way to tell your story. But anyway, you make your you make your 2 to 3 minute video, you submit it online, and in a month or so, some Frontier developers are going to make a little panel, they're going to review all the entries, and they're going to give out a bunch of prizes, including like, there's a Elgato Stream Deck, which is a really cool thing for streaming. Lets you control your OBS with like a little pad and like bring up certain graphics and certain sounds and stuff and not have to tab out to OBS and all this stuff. It's actually very, I was considering getting one myself. It's a very useful little thing. Some HyperX and Corsair goodies. HyperX make RAM, Corsair make a bunch of different gaming and PC peripherals in general. A Jurassic World Evolution bobby pin, which is of course the most exciting part of all of it. And, oh, we're about to come inside. And perhaps most excitingly, although not surprisingly, well, that's what I was going to say, surprisingly not a copy of Jurassic World Evolution, but, you know, we already have Jurassic World Evolution, obviously. Herp derp. The Ian Malcolm Funko Pop, the brand new Ian Malcolm Funko Pop, well, not brand new, it came out a couple months ago now. Do I not have infinite feeders on? What the bloody Nora? The brand new Ian Malcolm Funko Pop, the really cool one. It's really rare, it's actually really difficult to get hold of these days. This is probably a good chance to get hold of it for some of you guys at home. So, I am going to try to enter this, a 2 to 3 minute video. I thought we could give general ideas, maybe you guys hear something you like, you guys want to give me ideas, you know, whatever I do go for, if I decide to do this, I will upload it right here on the channel. And right now I have no ideas. I've come here to my Isla Nublar Botanical Gardens park because I think this is probably the most creative park I've got so far, at least in terms of sheer design. You know, there's a lot of very fairly unique individual exhibits over here. I love how this one looks, for example. I think the best bet you're going to do, because Jurassic World Evolution is quite hard to control, say, individual dinosaurs or individual guests, your best bet is probably a dinosaur documentary of some description. Think back to Walking with Dinosaurs and stuff like that. What you need to do is basically personalize Terry the Triceratops here. Give me a sec. That's how you spell Terry. Okay, Twerry. Twerry you, because of my spelling. Twerry you the Triceratops and her birth into the world and her trials and tribulations. She makes friends, she makes lovers, she makes enemies, she fights, she dies, whatever. You tell the tale of your dinosaur. But alternatively, you could tell the tale of your entire park. You could do like a guided park tour. You can talk over the top of your video. You can include outside sounds as well if you want to bring in some explosions and stuff for God knows what reason. You could do that as well. You just have to make sure you've cleared out all the copyright issues, because I assume Frontier want to upload these to their own channel. Shut up, phone. I'm talking to YouTube. I'm kind of just rambling at YouTube, if we're honest. Where's my monorail? I want to hop back on. There we are. Oh, look at that gate in the distance. Yeah. So, on we go. I love this park, man. I love this park. We're about to go over the Sinoceratops exhibit and Deinonychus Hill. Now, Deinonychus Hill is on the left. Sinoceratops Swamp is on the right. You can't actually spot the Deinonychus from the monorail. What we could do is curve the monorail to the left and put it on a hill so it goes over the top of the Deinonychus exhibit. That might be pretty cool. But there's our Sino Swamp anyway, with our little Pippo pool on the right-hand side. So you could do this kind of thing, and you could affect like a documentarian voice. You could go all Attenborough on it and kind of try to give it some gravitas and talk about your different dinosaurs, name them all, give them some personality, try to make it funny, try to make it entertaining, and hopefully win yourself some really cool stuff. If you guys want to see me give this a go, of course I will give it a go as well. Let me know some ideas down below. Do my work for me, basically. I'm thinking at the moment a park tour is a pretty good idea. Following an individual dinosaur is a pretty good idea. Maybe narrating a dinosaur fight like it's a boxing match, something like that. Maybe something to do with a storm on the way. You know, you could build up, you could record your park in a light storm, in a heavy storm, and then have the Twister come and sort of narrate the destruction of Twister, bring in some sound effects. Maybe follow around one specific guest. The problem is guests and Twisters don't really react that well, but you could follow one specific guest and tell their story, you know, hang the camera behind them as they're running. Is my park shut? I think my park shut. I was about to go follow a guest. Why's my park shut? No idea. Oh, because it wasn't finished yet. We never did the grand opening. Oh, well. So you can follow behind a guest, and there's a Twister behind them, and they're running, and they're running, and they're running, and then the Twister stops, but it breaks through the exhibit of the T-Rex, and instead that guest gets eaten by a T-Rex. You know, give it a little bit of a twist. There's a lot of really cool stuff you could do. You could build a park specifically to record this video, and I'd say the prizes are pretty worth it. It's a 2 to 3 minute video, which doesn't sound like a lot, but when you're stitching together a lot of frames, this will actually take quite a little bit of work if any of you at home are considering it. If you're looking for programs and help and stuff like that to record, I'll tell you what I used to record. It's a program called Action. You can buy it on Steam, and that'll keep it updated and stuff like that. I've been using Action for about 6 years now, something like that, a very, very long time, and it has become by far my most trusted recording program. So if you've been looking for a recording program, you could use that. It will cost a little bit of money. In terms of free programs, you are pretty limited. There isn't much out there. I'm sure there are some. Fraps has a free version, but it's terrible, and Fraps is terrible in general. Please don't use Fraps if you're trying to record videos. If you want a cheap mic for about 30 quid or so, Blue Yeti Snowball, which is what I used again for a very, very long time, is always a good idea. Even if it's going to take a long time for processing and stuff, just try to get your video up to like 1080p, you know, keep the quality nice and high. That kind of thing will matter. It just makes like a nicer initial impact. If you are on PC and you want to use NVIDIA, Ansel, that's Alt F2, so that will take away all this stuff. Now, you guys might be able to see the UI on the right, but if you don't run your recording program, when you come over here to your dinosaurs, hello, loves, okay, you could tell a love story between two dinosaurs, two Spinosauruses, and you hit snap like so, boop, that would actually take a photo of those two dinosaurs without the UI. So maybe you could do like a, just having an idea here, we're building this idea. So we're going to do the birth of our Triceratops, right? And then you take that same Triceratops to loads of different environments. You put it in a swamp, you put it up in the hills, meeting different dinosaurs, and you'd overlay like Polaroid pictures. You take the photos with Ansel and you'd turn them into Polaroid pictures via Photoshop. It would be a super easy thing to do. And then you would, excuse me, God, my throat was exploding. Not in a good way. Wow, don't even know what that means, but it sounds bad. And then you could, like, you know, like holiday snap, slap them over the top, put some jaunty music over the top, and it's like, yeah, holiday time, and this is Terry meeting a Tyrannosaurus Rex, this is Terry meeting Bob, the scientist guy who wanders around the park. You could just have some fun with it and build some personality. I think building personality and trying to just enjoy yourselves is very, very important, this kind of thing. A lot of you at home will be sitting there thinking, oh, well, I've never really recorded before, I don't really know how to do it, blah, blah, blah. I'm pretty sure that doesn't really matter. It's about your idea, it's about the concept. Work on developing the idea, and then the rest will kind of just fall into place. But like I said, I will link all the information below. I just figured a lot of you won't see this. A lot of people don't go on the subreddit. I never go on the official forums, personally. I use Reddit for all of my information for Jurassic World Evolution. And I know a lot of you use me for all of your Jurassic World Evolution information. So, you know, I figured we'd get it out there because Frontier are running this cool little competition. There are prizes as well for not just first, but second and third, I believe. But check all the official details down below. And that is about all I have to talk about. This wasn't really a planned video, in case you can't tell. I just wanted to ramble for a little bit, but I'm quite excited. I'm going to give this a go. I'm open to suggestions. Obviously, if you're planning to enter it, don't give me ideas, because use them for yourself. Obviously, that makes a lot more sense. But if there's an idea that you really like, maybe an idea you'd want to see come to life, being out of the game, your PC can't record and game at the same time, which is unfortunately a problem for a lot of people, stuff like that, then hey, feel free to leave some suggestions down below. And if I like yours, maybe I'll go for it and we'll do our own little best in slot entry. Maybe I wouldn't officially enter, because I think that would feel mean. And I suspect Frontier would purposely not pick me, even if it was the best thing in the world, just because, you know, I've not got ties with the company, but, you know, when I met them and all this, it would seem like favouritism, even if it never was. So I probably won't enter, but I might make my own entry, if you know what I mean. And at the end of the day, this has given me a little bit of idea. I'd like to start doing this in the future with you guys at home, maybe seeing your guys' parks, doing little park competitions, doing some unique stuff, maybe once a month, giving away some copies of the game or some other stuff like that, we shall see. The vacuum cleaner has started to go, so I'm going to go. Thank you for joining me so much. I will link the details down below. Go check them out. Let me know what you think. Are you going to enter this competition? Really good to see some community involvement from Frontier. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Quick little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.